Well, political reporter Matt Moran has been following Tony Abbott all week. And Matt, this moment has been a long time coming for the man who would become Australia's new Prime Minister. How did Election Day pan out for him?
Well, Tony Abbott started at a surf lifesaving club in his seat of Warringah this morning. I tell you what, he went on a media blitz again, trying to get all the voters he can. He was joined by his family. He then voted. And generally, there was a pretty good reception for him at his particular seat. He then went to Kingsford Smith, and there were supporters and also protesters there. And interestingly, the Labor candidate and the Liberal candidate had to help a get-up worker who fainted. They carried him into the shade, so a bit of bipartisanship today. Now, after Kingsford Smith, Tony Abbott headed to Barton, and he went to a school, and we saw some quite boisterous protesters there, and his security detail actually had to basically cut short the trip. Now, currently I'm in the seat of McMahon in Western Sydney. Tonight, Tony Abbott will be in the city and he will be celebrating, we think, with his Liberal supporters.
Thanks to Matt Moran reporting there live from Western Sydney. Well, meanwhile, 10 Sandra Sully is at the Four Seasons Hotel in Sydney with the Abbott team. And Sandra, what's the mood like there?
Well, Matt, I'd have to say it's cautious optimism and restrained excitement, really. Still pretty quiet. Plenty of coalition staffers behind us preparing the room for what they hope is going to be their biggest night. And the media are here in force. Glad to see, I think, the end of a 33-day campaign. As you know, Tony Abbott has run a pretty disciplined and effective campaign, and he's hoping that just behind me in a few hours' time, he will be declared Australia's 28th Prime Minister. I was here in 2010, and at that time in particular, they believed then that victory was within grasp, but of course they were denied right at the finish line, and they will be holding their breath until they are absolutely certain that they own the prize. So not long to go now, and I think on behalf of the rest of Australia, we hope it goes quickly.
I'm sure that's true. Thanks very much to Sandra Sully reporting live there.